Well, good morning, church family. It is Thursday, April the 9th, and it is kind of muggy out here this morning. It poured down rain last night, and which is great because it goes along with what our devotion is this morning. But before we get into our devotion, I want to remind you about this coming Sunday. It is Resurrection Sunday, Easter Sunday, and because of the pandemic that's going on, because of the situation that we're all in, we cannot meet together. However, at 10 a.m. on Sunday morning, we are having Easter at home, and it will be brought to you live. Pastor Zach has been praying and seeking God during this time of what message that God wants him to deliver on Sunday. And so it will be happening at 10 a.m. on Sunday morning. And if you cannot catch us live on Sunday morning, it will be replaying throughout the day on Sunday. So if you have to work or anything like that, it will be playing live throughout the day on Sunday. But I would encourage you to be there at 10 a.m. on Sunday morning to interact and to just see what God is doing for us. That's at fbfirst.com. And you can find all the information there and watch us live on Sunday morning at 10 a.m. So, but with that, we're going to jump into the scriptures today. It poured down rain last night, and I love the rain. It's refreshing. To me, it's reminds me of God pouring his love upon us. And I just, as the old song goes, I love a rainy night, right? It's refreshing, and I find joy in it. And today's devotion, is about that and where we find our joy. And I'm just going to read the passage, a couple of verses, and then I just wanted to tell you the truth, and then we're going to move on. So here we go. It comes out of Joel chapter 2, verse 21 through 23. And it says this, it says, "Fear not, don't be afraid." That's our verse, our little phrase. "Fear not, O land, be glad and rejoice, for the Lord has done great things." And I know it's hard to see that, but fear not. Be glad and rejoice, for the Lord has done great things. He has done great things, and he will continue to do great things. "Fear not, you beasts of the field, for the pastures of the wilderness are green. The tree bears its fruit. The fig tree and vine give their full yield. Be glad, O children of Zion, and rejoice in the Lord your God. For he has given the early rain for your vindication. He has poured down for you the abundant rain." And the early and the latter rain as before. "He has poured down for you the abundant rain." And that just reminds me of him pouring down his abundant love for us. And so the truth of the matter is today, God is our joy. That is the underlying truth. God is our joy. We find joy in him, not in our circumstances, not in the situations that we're in. We find our joy. If you are a follower of Christ, if you have confessed Jesus as your Lord and Savior and believed in your heart that he rose from the dead, we find our joy in him. And so today, what I want to encourage you to do is I want you to look past your circumstance, look past what's going on in our lives, and I want you to find joy in Jesus. See what he has done for you. Look around and be thankful and rejoice in the Lord, because he has showered his love upon us just like he showered the rain down last night. So I want to encourage you with that today. Who we're going to be thankful for? This is going to sound funny, but this morning I'm thankful for my garbage man. My garbage man came early this morning, and I met him out front because I had to untie my garbage. And so it was a cool morning, and I was very thankful that he was there, because I'd have a lot of junk in my house, a lot of trash in my house, if he wasn't there every Thursday. So I want to be thankful for my garbage man today. And I'm going to rejoice because God has given me the opportunity to have a garbage man. And then also what I want to pray for today is, and I haven't done this before yet, I want to pray for the people that are looking to find a cure for the virus. I've never prayed for that yet. And so I want to pray specifically for those people this morning, that God would give them wisdom. Okay, so let's pray. God, I just thank you for who you are. I thank you for your son, Jesus, and the grace and mercy that comes through him. Lord, I want to thank you, and I just want to just be grateful for my garbage man this morning. And thank you that he was here, and he is serving us, Lord, and serving me. So I just praise you for that. And God, I want to pray for the people that are creating, looking for ways to make a cure for this virus. Lord, it may be out there. They may have to create it. I don't know, God. But I just want to pray for them. I pray you give them wisdom and give them discovery and let them be able to find something that can heal our land, heal the people, God. You can heal our land, and God, but I pray that you would find something, that would give them wisdom, Lord, as they're looking for a way to cure the virus. And God, I just want to thank you for who you are and the fact that we have joy in you, and that we can rejoice and be glad. And so that's my prayer today, that we are able to see things around us and rejoice and be glad in it. In Jesus' name, amen. So what I want you to do today is keep your eyes open, as my wife says, have your God goggles on, and look at things and rejoice and be glad. And let's see things that God has given us and pour down abundantly upon us. Again, as always, turn down the volume of the media, turn up the truth of God's word, and in Christ there is hope. I hope you're encouraged today. God bless you. We'll see you tomorrow.